your nine item. So item 10 to 16, your 7, right? It's under organized approach. 17 to 25. Actually, you can just jump, okay? Take notes on that. 26 to 32 is this approach, and 33 to 40 is hard work approach. After you answer, okay, answering your questions, completed your questionnaire. So now is the scoring here. Okay? Usually you will key in it, what you call it SPS. Correct? The software to determine okay, whether you're all under which thermostat. But here you can do it manually. Manually meaning you just count it in. Right? So you have a little skill or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Then you start up for item 1 to 9, okay? The first one 1 to 9. If you say you answer 1. Okay, all is 1, 1, 1, 1, 9 items, so your scoring will be 9. Okay, if you say 9, meaning you are not under motivational approach. Later I will inform, I will tell you, okay, what are the characteristics okay, of your or personality of yourself, if you say you fall under motivational. So you just sum up. If you say you have a score 2 okay, or 1, then you just add up. So for item 10 to 16, they say you go under 1. So the 7 items, right? If you say all under 1, meaning there's 7. You add up all together. Based on the item. Okay, item. Based on the item. Item 1 to 9, assume that you answer 1 for all. Okay? Item 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you answer 1, 1. So at the end, you will get 9 only. Correct? Meaning you are not adapting this motivational learning stuff. Right? If you say your score is 38, right? So it's more than 36. See the scoring for? More than 36. Right? So more than 36, meaning you are adapting this motivational learning stuff. So under motivational learning stuff, I will inform you what your personality or your credit. So for item 10 to 16, you can say assume that you answer 1 only for this scoring. Okay? So assume that you have 7 questions. So answer 1 to 1 becomes 7 only. So 7 meaning you are not adapting the organized learning stuff.
So that's why some will prefer to study by one.
Okay, if you don't understand, then you can refer to a lecturer or a tutor. So for those who adapting hard work approach, hard work, students will obtain information from various sources, and not only from the textbook or from lecture slide, yeah, or from this tutorial from others as well. So we'll submit earlier on time. Yeah, earlier or on time. You need to submit your assignment earlier. How many of you will submit earlier? Usually last minute, right? Or maybe on time. Yes, on time. Maybe you say, okay, before 12 or at 12. So before 12, maybe 5, okay, 11:59, and then you will submit. Correct? So usually it will be like this. You won't be submit early, maybe 1 or 2 groups instead. Then what else? Prepare own notes from revision books. Then beside your lecture slide, beside your tutorial, so you prepare your own notes. Alright, so you will not give up easily. They say if you know how to answer your questions, you will try your best, right? So to search the information from outside. How to solve this assignment, for example. Then maybe the assignment question given to you. So you won't ask your teacher first or your lecturer first. Then you will search from outside, maybe from the net. Okay, so you see how to solve this kind of problem. Okay, so example is so if they say you are adapting this hard work approach. For motivational, these are motivational, meaning learning techniques that influenced by your teacher, okay, by your lecturer, friends, and family. Okay, usually this one is from item 2 and 7. You see your item 2 and 7, 2 until 7. Okay? To obtain higher marks is very important task for me. Right? Important marks, higher marks. So happy with the all tasks given. Then afraid my lecturer complain of my work. Then usually you will see. Or you won't do things like in mind the teacher you need to know. And for you, if you say you are anything this kind of learning style, then you will perform the best that you can. Right? And you will afraid that you are unable to catch up on your study, so you will study every day. Then you won't wait until last minute when you study. Right? So this one is the hard work. That's why you say this one is motivational, then you won't give up. Then you will link with the challenge to obtain the higher marks. Okay, how to get higher marks in your study? So you will study every day, right? So you will do go and seek advice from your lecturer or your tutors. In all the subjects, not to say only the subject you like. Then maybe you like computation, so you only focus on computation. It's not that suitable. Okay? In your study, you will focus theory and the computation as well. For organized approach, okay. Nature and behavior in managing time effectively. Okay. So you must have enough time to prepare for your exam. Okay. Example like midterm. Okay. Midterm. Maybe 9 to 10:30 is your exam. So 11 to 12 is another exam. So within half an hour, is it the time for you to do your revision for another subject? Not suitable, right? For sure you will do it earlier, right? Although they already arranged for you. Or maybe for your final exam. Morning. Paper A. Afternoon, another paper. So for sure you will prepare your revision earlier. It's not within the time. Then after your paper one, only you go and revision for paper two. And that's not a suitable way for you to do revision. Okay? That's why the midterm time, alright? So last week is my midterm subject. The morning of exam. So after 15 minutes my paper, what they do? They will come and see me, 1 or 2 students, not all. Okay? Maybe this kind of students is under which is not under organized approach. Okay? So that's why this kind of students that come and see me saying that I have no time for me to go for the midterm. So can I go for this exam first? Alright? So what is my answer? You may say this kind of advice, will you accept? So no. Okay? So you say okay, you go for your midterm first. Because what? You have to prepare your preparation for a midterm earlier, okay, a week or maybe before this midterm. Okay? As I told you during the week 1, so your exam is on this week 9. Right? So you have to prepare this throughout this week 9, you have to do your preparation. Okay? If they say you are in organized approach, okay, under organized approach. So you will do what else? Enough, okay. Answering questions in organized detail and textbook. Okay, when this you have, let's say you are approaching, yeah, you attend this organized learning style, you will answer the question in organized. Sometimes I see the questions, right? You will answer question 2 first, okay? 2B, then later on 3A, later on 4B, then question 5, later on back to question 1. Alright? So this kind of student is not under organized approach. So usually they will answer very detailed. Give example, then prove with, illustrate with diagram, example, timeline, all this. Alright? So they can get higher marks. So you may see some students say, why I can answer but at the end I get very less, okay? I can answer it for my final exam. Why at the end I only obtain a C? Okay, I know that I can get A, alright, but maybe you lack of your explanation. Alright, maybe you only give 0.4. Instead of 10 marks, you only give 0.4, so half mark, okay? Each one half mark, at the end you get only 2 marks. Then 2/10. So at the end you will get less. Okay? Instead of A, you get this C. And that is the reason why you get less. So in order to perform better achievement in your academic, right? So you have to give a detail, okay, organize and careful. Right? So you have to read all these keywords, highlight the keywords. Okay, highlight the keywords. During the lecture times, okay, so when the lecturer mentions your the keyword, you will highlight it. Then the keyword itself you can expand the explanation. Expand from the keyword. So for those who are under organized approach, applying this kind of learning stuff, so you will do this mind map study, then mind map. Meaning, okay, from one topic, the main topic, what are the subtopics? Under this subtopic, what are these topic or the keywords that you're going to highlight? Then for this topic or this subtopic. So from here, you can just do your final revision. So very easy. Very, very easy. So from the mind map itself, you can see what are the keywords that you're going to elaborate or explain. Then you can say this kind of question. So for the surface approach, the surface meaning you indicate less involvement in your learning activities. Okay, only surface. You will read, okay, the lecture slide, you only read the first two lecture slides. Then the book only, you read the first two, okay, two pages. So they will just study on the information that is important. Then within the lecture say, okay, you have to highlight this one. Yeah, this one very important, so you put two stuff here, okay, on the lecture slide. So you only study on that two stuff only. Okay, they say the lecture slide, then lecturer inform you, okay, this one very important, you have to understand the concept. So you only highlight these two stuff. So you only study on that. Emphasize or focus on that. If they say your lecturer just turn the questions, huh? You don't know how to answer. You do not put any effort to study more. You just study only on this highlighted information only. And if I say you are under surface approach. So you prefer to memorize all the facts. Memorize all. Okay, like photocopy machine at the end. Your final exam, right? So you say exactly same with this lecture slide, for example. Or exactly same with the textbook, okay, word by word. Even further, no miss. And no miss at all. So I even had this kind of answer script before. Okay, so this one, this kind of students, I will see or under surface approach. Okay, so I put as that. So you prefer to memorize and prepare very few important notes, very less notes. Then when you do assignment or your study, you will need detailed explanation. Okay, very detailed. You will ask Miss or Sir, how to do this one? Okay, how to obtain this information? Alright, this kind of investment you are under surface approach. Then you want to go in deep to search for the information first before you can seek advice from your lecturer or from your student. Alright, so this you are this kind of student under surface approach. Okay, actually five only: deep, network, motivational, organized, and surface. And five. So which one you fall in? So you will quickly change your item. Okay? From the surface one you quickly change to this scoring. You may say surface you change to scoring one, I guess better. Okay? You will say for item 34 until 40, okay? Like item 39 is indicate that you are not easily give up, okay, for item 39. For 34, 35, and 36, 33, you will say you tick or you circle on the first one, that's better. Okay, the first one. Actually, it depends on the item. Okay, which one you are following? This one is for you to respect. Just now what I mentioned to you on the finding. Right? So you come in and say knowledge comes with learning. Okay? So skill comes with experience. Okay? You experience more than you can get more skill. Skill is different. So attitudes never come. Develop your own. So there are three things you cannot recover in life. Okay? The word after the state. Example, you already score or you quarrel with someone. Alright? So when you quarrel with someone, the person who received your word, then they will remember forever. But when you quarrel with what you voice out, actually maybe 1 or 2 seconds you will remember. Alright? So after it stays, at the moment after it hits. Okay, they say you miss out this maybe this exam or this midterm, right? Maybe you can go for replacement. But the replacement one for sure is very difficult compared to your main final prospect. And the time after it's gone, right? So we have to so be careful. And the learning is a pressure that will follow a owner anyway. Right? So once you learn, actually it's a lifelong learning. It will follow you. The knowledge that you gain, it will follow you forever. Very nice and juicy grapes, right? So the root of the educations are bitter, but the fruits is sweet. Okay? Actually, it's quoted from this Aristotle. Aristotle is one of these sociologists. So that's